Some of my favorite memories as a child were of those times where we were taking long road trips. You know, I grew up in the northern side, Santa Cruz. So when we would take trips down to Mayaro or Sandy Grande or these faraway places, it was often a bonding time for us as a family. And in the backdrop of all the fun and games and exploration that we did were often the cars that we took. For instance, my dad owned Kingswood. He owned a Holden Commodore. He owned Mazda 626, Peugeot 306. These were big cars, and it was a perfect car for all five of us, sometimes even more, to crowd in and just go out and explore Trinidad and Tobago. And now that I'm a father, I want to make sure that I have those same experiences with my family, right? I want to find out what's the perfect car for a long road trip. So to celebrate the launch of season two and to kind of get back to that roots of taking those long family trips all over Trinidad and Tobago, the producers came up with a fantastic idea. Let's get a vehicle and let's try to make as much of a loop as we can around Trinidad.
Say that again.
As much of a loop as we can in under 6 hours. So we're leaving here at midnight and we're going to try to catch the sunrise at Maracas Bay, which is supposed to be at 5:57 tomorrow morning. So the car I'll be driving and focusing on for most of this trip is this 2020 Chevy Equinox. Now it's a large family vehicle, and so far just picking it up from Lifestyle and getting it here to the studio, it's a pretty smooth ride. So I'll be telling you a lot more about this Chevy Equinox as we go on our journey. All right, so we just left the studio and we haven't really gotten far yet. We're just trying to get on to the highway to kind of start the first leg of our journey, which is to head down to D Bay. So we've left Chase Village and we're heading down to D Bay, and that's going to be the first stretch or the first leg of the run. Now once we get to D Bay, that's when things get a little tricky. The original plan was to cut across from on Pinap Rock Road all the way to Mayaro, but I've been warned by several friends and crew members that that road is not a road to be trifled with. So we're kind of going to wiggle our way through the southern leg, right, to find our way into Mayaro. From Mayaro, cut up to Grandy. From Grandy, around Valencia, down to the Arima Bypass Road, up to the North Coast Road, and hopefully get to Maracas Bay in time to catch the sunrise. So that's the plan. So let's see how that goes. So it's about 4 minutes after we started our trip, and apparently we're already lost. I was following these guys to the highway to get out of Chase Village, but apparently they don't know what we're doing. But luckily, this car does come with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. So all I have to do is sync my phone to the 7-inch MyLink touchscreen over here, and I won't have to depend on, those people for directions. Here we go. So we are kind of in the back roads of San Fernando area, somewhere down here. And the car has decided to make this chiming sound. And I have no idea what the car is trying to tell me. It's not seatbelt warning, it's not camera guy seatbelt. There's no warning lights on the dash.
One eternity later.
I don't know. Oh, it's have another phone. Alright, so we're passing C3 Center. According to Waze, we're on the Solomon Hohoi Highway, heading south towards Pinal now. So far, I have to say that the Equinox is pretty nice. It's got a sprightly 1.5 liter turbo engine, which when you hit about 2500 RPMs and you just, if you're cruising at 2500 RPMs and then you just punch it, that turbo kicks in really quickly. Though it makes a lot of engine noise, but it's pretty responsive and I like it. It's very peppy. So this 1.5 liter turbo puts out 170 brake horsepower. It's got 203 pound feet of torque. It's a 6-speed automatic front wheel drive. All right. Leather interior. Not that you could see it right now, but it's got a really huge panoramic sunroof and it's really nice. So far, so good. And a lot more driving to go. Yeah.
Auto Accessories R Us, your premier choice for cutting-edge auto accessories. Your car is everything, and we have everything you need, from headlights, taillights, fog lamps, grills, body kits, mats, filters, mirrors, waterproof bulbs, and so much more. We specialize in parts for the Toyota Hiace and strive to be the first in selection, quality, and customer service. Call us today at 665-6650. Or visit us at 105 Karani Savannah Road, Charleville, Chagones.
TrinGlobe Media Limited, a versatile broadcasting and media production company, brings to you dynamic multimedia solutions to cater to all your digital needs. We provide professional multi-camera digital live streaming of your socially distanced event, such as consultations, weddings, and even virtual parties to any social media platform in fine style. The world has ground to a halt, but you don't have to. Call 273-4926 or email tringlobemedia@gmail.com.
Do you want your four-wheel drive to be a capable and reliable off-road vehicle? Well, down at Monster Mods, we do a variety of four-wheel drive modifications, ranging from suspension upgrades to body lifts to even wheels and tires, you name it. We have it all down at Monster Mods for your four-wheel drive. Give us a call if you want your four-wheel drive to be built bigger, built better.
Renting a vehicle? Come to Save A Lot. We have a wide variety of fuel-efficient cars and SUVs at the most affordable prices. Save A Lot has been providing Trinidad and Tobago with reliable rentals to meet a variety of transportation needs. From one-day rentals to short-term leasing, let Save A Lot get you behind the wheel of a vehicle quickly and affordably. Saving you time and money.
Rada Body Kits, located at 63 Camden Main Road, Coover. For all your auto body work and customization needs, we supply body kits for all makes and models, Japanese and European, by wholesale or retail, and we install. Check out our wide range of foreign use vehicles or drive away in one of our luxury brands. Rada Body Kits. Everything your vehicle needs under one roof.
So we are in the heart of, well, according to Waze, actually Waze is cracking me up right now, because after we got off the Solomon Hohoi Highway, we ended up in Dubai. So we're in Dubai right now, and doing pretty good. I think a little bit of tiredness started to set in. Good news is, it's since we're making this trip at night, the road is pretty clear, there's not much traffic, so there's not much, you know, to frustrate us as we drive. Just enjoying the bay in my Chevy Equinox. You know what Trinidad's missing? Trinidad is missing 24-hour double spot. How come nobody sells a double 24 hours? I mean, people are on the road at all hours of the night, all hours of the day. Why it is I can't find a 24-hour doubles vendor? I mean, there's 2020, come on, man. Somebody needs to be out at 2 o'clock in the morning selling doubles. Also, what's up with the random mansions just on the side of the road in DB? Like, what's happening down here that I'm not aware of? I mean, these houses are huge. Huge, I tell you. Look.
Indian Expo.
Yeah, always going out of business. But never closing. Oh, look. This is the bamboo of the south, boy. The bamboo of the south, Bix! Shout out Bix. Bix, yo, you get big up. All right, later. Actually, down here, there's a really cool off-roading place. Actually, down here is where, what's the off-roading? Look right there, ABS off-roading, oi! Oi, I'm pulling over by ABS off-roading. I just passed my boy Sean there from ABS Off-Road. And what up, Sean? I'm in the bay. All right. What about coconut people? How come it have them 24-hour coconut people? It have a real nice coconut lady that is sell coconuts outside of ABS Off-Road. Why is she not there 24 hours a day? I'm in the bay right now on coconut. Where are you? Where are you? Slacking. You miss a sale, you understand? You miss a sale. Catwaru tracer on here. You know, the thing about beautiful Trinidad and Tobago is even at night, it's really just such a scenic place, you know?
Exit the roundabout onto Clark Road, then turn left onto Wallaby Drive.
Check out Pinal's fire station. Pinal, that is a nice fire station. Congratulations, Pinal, on a well-built, beautiful fire station. That's nice. Big up to Pinal people. White lines in the area. Just, checking in here with Waze to make sure that, you know, Satnarayan Trace is really the road I want to be on. But I must say, Mr. Satnarayan Trace people, that those are some sneaky speed bumps. Some well-placed speed bumps on the right before the hill. Not that I was thinking about, you know, gunning it or anything. No, I'm just saying that those are some really nice, well-placed. So, Satnarayan Trace with the Chevy Equinox. White lines is in your area.
Rada Body Kits, located at 63 Camden Main Road, Coover. For all your auto body work and customization needs, we supply body kits for all makes and models, Japanese and European, by wholesale or retail, and we install. Check out our wide range of foreign used vehicles or drive away in one of our luxury brands, Rada Body Kits. Everything your vehicle needs under one roof.
Auto Accessories R Us, your premier choice for cutting-edge auto accessories. Your car is everything, and we have everything you need, from headlights, taillights, fog lamps, grills, body kits, mats, filters, mirrors, waterproof bulbs, and so much more. We specialize in parts for the Toyota Hiace and strive to be the first in selection, quality, and customer service. Call us today at 665-6650 or visit us at 105 Karani Savannah Road, Charleville, Chaguanas.
Luxury. An experience that awakens your awareness of style, comfort, sophistication, and performance. Welcome to the new home of luxury and a new experience in automotive buying. Come in today for a test drive and experience it yourself at LaFasse Motors. The new home of luxury.
Do you want your four-wheel drive to be a capable and reliable off-road vehicle? Well, down at Monster Mods, we do a variety of four-wheel drive modifications, ranging from suspension upgrades to body lifts to even wheels and tires, you name it. We have it all down at Monster Mods for your four-wheel drive. Give us a call if you want your four-wheel drive to be built bigger, built better.
Nighttime driving, eh? Driving at night is actually one of the most dangerous times to drive, you know.
Continue on Rotten Road for 1.5 kilometers.
So, glares from oncoming vehicle, you know, and of course the fact that your vision is a lot less, you can see a lot less further at night. And that's why it's recommended that you reduce your speed when driving at nighttime. Just because your reaction time, everything is just so much, it's kind of hindered, you know. But the temptation is there because there's no one on the road. I mean, if you look, there's just no one on the road right now. But when you become a man, and you get a license, you have to put away childish things, because having a license is always fun, and freedom is also a high level of responsibility that comes with it. So you need to take your time when driving at night. Be safe between the white lines, you know. So right now we are on Pinal Rock Road. And you know, if you were a student in like a Maruga Secondary growing up, you'd have to be up at like 5:30 in the morning to catch the free maxi that used to come and pick kids up on this street right here. I mean, those were the days, you know what I mean? Now, you're taking Zoom classes and stuff like that, online school. Kids these days have it so easy. They don't know about getting up at 4 o'clock in the morning, bathing in cold water, just to go to school, you know? So, Pinal Road, me and the Chevy, we see you. We see, we know your struggle. Although this is more like a Pinal paved road, you know, because I ain't seen any rocks.
12 seconds late.
Apparently I spoke too soon about Pinal Rock Road, because it was really nice on back there, but up here it looks more like it looks more like the Blanchichet's road on the North Coast side. So I guess the two ends of the spectrum have it real rough, you know. But we still pushing through.
Hey, what's up?
Okay, good. This guy literally came out the car in the middle of
Pinal.
The
road.
Pinal Rock Road.
I guess it's something any question.
Dude.
Yeah, one pants. Yeah, man.
Dude.
Man, a dog.
You all know it have people, don't you?
Yeah.
Yes. You never know what's around the corner. So, update. Guayaguayari Road and the road conditions have not improved. So I think in the last hour we've probably gone about 15 kilometers, which is not a lot. So in terms of making it to Maracas to catch the sunrise, not looking very good right now. So we are not making good time at all. It's amazing though, because when you live most of your life in the Port of Spain area, even central San Fernando areas, you know, you're accustomed with a kind of certain standard of roads. But this Guayaguayari Road, the Pinal Rock Road, the, what was the other road we were on? Start with the S? Saunders Trace Road or whatever it is. They are not roads. There are no roads in South. In Deep South. Look at this bridge. You know what I mean? What kind of bridge is that? But my point is this. These bad roads down here have eaten up a lot of our time. And although it's been quite fun, it's very time consuming. But that's all part of the adventure. It's all part of the adventure. It's all part of the experience. That's what road tripping is about. Alright, on to the next one.
Yeah, let's have a nice juvenile.
Rio Claro, I'm Rich. I'm in your area. And now pass your police station and your courts there. Continue for 20. I see fence had a spot down here too. But there's some real bad roads in these areas, man. Some real bad roads. I'm feeling real bad for there, because I don't know how all your car making out in these kind of conditions, but I wish you all the best in Rio Claro. And if you're looking for a vehicle that could take and handle the road down here, check out the Chevy Equinox, because it's doing real good. Doing real good. The thing I like about it so far is that it's really comfortable. You know, despite all the bumps and stuff, it holds itself pretty well. And in terms of the cabin space, it's pretty roomy in here. My seat is in a comfortable position and I can fit comfortably behind myself, and that's always a good thing because I'm 6'2", right? Tons of cargo space. I'll show you the trunk a little later. Tons of cargo space. We're doing good. All right, folks. 4:15 a.m. update, and we just entered the Sandy Grande area, trying to decide if we have enough time to take the Manzanil, the Blanchiches Road to Maracas Bay, or if by doing so we're gonna miss the deadline, which is sunrise, which is supposed to be at 6 o'clock. So the question at hand is, can we make Sandy Grande to Maracas Bay in an hour and 45 minutes? That's the question right there.
Alright, so we're in the final stretch here now. The sky is starting to turn that milky blue color. It's not dark anymore. You can actually see a little bit of light coming through. And we're still not at the beach. We're trying to be as safe as possible, trying to maneuver our way through this North Coast Road. But I think the burning ball of fire might be trying to make an early appearance today. So we still have a little bit of ways to go before we actually hit the beach. So we're hoping, we're praying that we actually make it and that this journey all through the night would not be in vain.
At certain points throughout the night, I didn't think we were going to make it, you know? Everything seemed to be working against us. Time was working against us. We took too long on the southern part of the run. You know, the roads down there were really bad and we were tired, we were exhausted. But as you juxtapose that to what's happening in the world right now with the big C word, the big corona and everything, and how that's impacted us here, is Trinbagonians. I think as long as we have the right people around us to keep us motivated, as long as we have the right mindset not to give up, to keep persevering, to keep moving forward, we're going to make it. We're going to see the light at the end of the tunnel. And it doesn't hurt to have the right vehicle as well.